dwarves and elves and the witcher too. We're here to bring it all to you. Hi kids, hi everybody. I've got a great story for you and starts like all the best stories do. Once upon an incredible time...
Once upon a time!
Oh, do shut up, sister dear. Once upon a time, and don't interrupt.
We're both on a break from the magic mirror, you know. She's Jekyllina, the goody good. And I'm Hydea,
the baddie bad. And I wish you'd be quiet till I tell everybody about the seven dwarfs.
Seven smelly, funny little men.
They're not funny little men, they're my friends.
There's no accounting for taste. Hey, here they come.
They're ugly, obnoxious, and a dumb man.
And you never find as many diamonds as we do.
I do, when they trump or line up back to their cottage for a club.
It's Soph's turn to cook. Oh no, I'm sick already.
Why can't one of you get married?
Too good cook.
Who'll marry us?
Let's get a McDonald's and forget about the wife.
Forget about nothing. Soph is cooking.
Oh, little men of shrunken sizes, you must prepare for big surprises. To unkept cottage will soon arrive a visitor fair who changed the jive.
So mark her well, just treat her right. You must protect the young Snow White.
Men.
Hush, Hydea. We can't all be perfect.
Imagine not knowing who Snow White is.
You all know who Snow White is, don't you, children?
Yes.
Well, let's meet her.
Miss Snow White. Poor, poor Snow White, who Queen Sylvaine, her stepmother, hates.
Yes, it's a shame.
Treats her like a skib.
Yes, it's really shameful. And Snow White is so beautiful and gentle and kind and... Here she is.
Hi, everybody. My name's Snow White and I'm so miserable I couldn't ball.
When I was young, I used to go to every dance and ball.
Who do you dance with, Nursey?
No one. That's why I used to ball.
Oh, Nurse Lysington, you are here trying to cheer me up.
And someone would want that. The way that rapping old hairpin treats you, it's criminal. Look at the rags she makes you wear.
That's just so my good dress doesn't get dirty.
As you scrub the floors, clean the windows, polish the shoes, put out the rubbish, empty the septic tank.
Oh, don't remind me.
Nursey, can I let you in on a secret? I've got my good dress on under my rag.
You have?
I heard a rumour that Prince Charming is to visit the palace, and well, just in case, I want to be ready.
Hello, girl. You look sensational in that dress. If Princey appears, off with the rags and flaunt it. Oh, why does that old tea leaf treat you the way she does?
I don't know, but I just hope and pray that someday soon my prince will come.
Hold me, never let me go on to you.
misery.
Yes, it's a shame.
Oh, no, it's not.
She's jealous.
And she's right. That Snow White is too beautiful.
Every day, that wicked queen stands before the magic mirror, and one of us has to tell her she's beautiful.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
Someday soon, real soon, we'll have to tell her the truth. You, O Queen, are fair, 'tis true, but Snow White's fairer far than you.
She'll do her not.
But I'm right. Next time she asks, we'll have to tell her the truth.
It's the Queen! Oh, it's stepmother! Oh, where can I hide?
Behind me, child! Behind me!
I'll hide ya.
Good morning, Your Majesty! The wonderfulest, kindest, most beautiful...
Shut up!
Chattering chipmunks and cluttered cobwebs. I'm the wicked queen, so vain, and I'm beautiful. And you best behave, or I'll turn you into frogs, do you hear? Frogs! Where's that awful, ugly stepdaughter of mine?
Who do you mean?
Don't be more stupid than you have to, you old scarecrow. Snow White.
Oh, Snow White, your dear little daughter, your sweet little...
She's not my daughter. What's that behind you? What are you hiding from me?
What? Who? Where?
Behind you! Ah, Snow White! Why aren't you in the cellar cleaning the cobwebs? They're inches thick! And what do you mean dressing up in that ugly, awful dress? Where's your working clothes? Well, where are they, you ungrateful wretch?
Here they are! Now keep your shirt on, Queen! Here, child, put it on and let's get to work in the cellar. Sharpen your knitting needles and we let a stray jacket out of the cobwebs for the old biddy!
Nurse Nightingale, I'm watching you. You're on a sticky wicket! Any more impudence or incompetence from you and you'll be bowed out.
A sore thing?
Oh, please, Queen Sylvain, please don't discharge my nurse. She's the only friend I have.
Ah, shivering swords up and sizzling sausages! Out of my sight! Nurse Nightingale, tell that imbecilic husband of yours, the Lord Chamberlain, to put a notice on the palace gate, informing the great unwashed that I want a couple of handymen for some special work.
Special work? What special work?
Cautious cockroaches and cantankerous caterpillars! How dare you question my orders? Get out, get out, get on with your grubby tasks. But be sure to engage a couple of heinous henchmen with not too many scruples.
Scruples? There's a damn few dead yokes round here. Come on, Snow White, let's make some space.
Alone at last. Now to consult my magic mirror. One so beautiful, I'm so gorgeous, I'm so glamorous, I can't help loving myself. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? And it better be me, you stupid twins, or I'll wipe away your silly grins.
You, O Queen, are fair, 'tis true. There's no one half so fair as you.
I knew it! I knew it! I feel pretty! You're so pretty! Da 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 da. Oh, Lord Chamberlain, we nearly played Bumps of Daisies there for a minute.
Your Queenliness, there's a long queue of applicants stretching miles down the Palace Avenue.
Oh?
The two vacancies.
Already? Interview them and pick a couple of handymen out that don't mind a little bit of dirty work. I feel pretty, you're so pretty. Da 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 da.
I don't know which is worse. When she's in her usual foul humour or in her I feel pretty humour after talking to the silly mirror.
Hey, chamber partner, come here till I give you.
Now, nurse, just because we're married doesn't mean we can canoodle on the job.
Oh, yeah? What kind of a husband are you at all?
It's coming on. Yeah, the job disappeared too.
We frightened the gizzards out of them.
Are we coming or going?
We want the job.
Oh, what job?
Don't mind him. He's one brick short of a load.
Then I'm afraid you won't do. I was bad and I was small.
Not now, Sauce.
Your nanny and daddy ran away from home.
Will you put a sock in it?
We were so poor, our rainbow was black and white.
Ignore him. He's going straight to the hospital for a minor operation on his head. He's having a brain put in.
They seem useless, but we'd have to go through the motions. Would you like an aperitif? What's that?
Yeah, ignorant Jobo. And a pair of teeth is a pair of French false teeth. Don't you know, Harry?
Where's that piece of sandpaper? Now for the test. What's this?
A map of the desert, sir.
My daddy had breakfast with Napoleon.
But Napoleon is dead.
Daddy did say he was awfully quiet. I don't believe this. What's your names?
I'm Rashers.
Say sir when you speak to me.
Oh, Sir Asher.
Who's he?
He's Sausage. Can I call him Sir Sausage too?
Who picks such stupid names?
Do you think your names are stupid? Do you know how Chinese are christened? They throw a heap of cutlery up into the air and listen to pick out their names. Ping Chang Fong Chong.
They don't look very bright.
Oh, I'm bright. I looked in the mirror last night with my eyes closed, so I know how I looked when I was asleep.
We're experts in geography and diplomacy and everything.
That's a coincidence. So, am I?
Oh, what do you think about China?
With a clash with the yellow tablecloth. Oh Lord, look out! Here she comes again! Here's trouble!
Your Highness, these are the only applicants.
Not very promising.
Oh, we promise you anything.
Fools!
Be gone and we're no fools. Pulled off crime in a century, never got caught.
Oh?
Hijacked the lorry load of laxatives. We're still on the run.
How long did you work in your last job?
35 years.
Impossible, you're not old enough.
Well, we worked overtime.
So you work fast? I'm so fast I switched off the light last night and I was in bed before the room got dark.
You could do, you and that useless wife of yours.
There's nothing wrong with her. That's a good funeral fucking cure. What are the wages like?
£50 a week.
Each?
Between.
Here now, we want double that.
Certainly. Instead of £50 a week, we'll pay you £50 a fortnight.
You see, a dumb cure that never got a parish. We'll take it, man.
Your Highness.
Oh, cheer that's us. We get another title. Sir, Your Highness, are they changing the usual names of halls?
Would you leave the royal presence?
Ma'am, if I never see you again, it'll be time enough.
Get out! Get out! Get out!
No wonder everyone's mad to work that one. The grave digger, the embalmer, the undertaker!
Shh, nursey, she'll hear you. Magic mirror, it's time you got to work again. Hurry up, let's get straight to the point. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? Tell me true and let all see that there's none so fair as me. Tell me I'm the best by far, with beauty like a villain star. Beautiful, you are a queen. Is brought in all the realm. Honest lips
see me in the middle of a cadenza?
The prince, your highness. The prince is here.
Prince? What prince?
The artist formerly known as Prince.
How dare you, Benjamin?
Wonder if she is a woman turned milk sir by just look
an amazing scene. Queen Sylvain seems peculiar, and as for Nurse Nightingale, wow!
Don't you dare criticize my nurse!
Hold on, Snow White. I wasn't criticizing her. In fact, I admire her. She's certainly not afraid of the Queen, but I don't understand. You say you're a princess, and Queen Sylvain says you're a servant.
I am a princess. The late king was my father. The queen is my stepmother. And I don't know why she hates me so much.
Oh, sure, you're imagining things, princess.
No, I'm not. Why else would she make me wear rags and treat me like a servant? Only for Nurse Nightingale and Lord Chamberlain, I don't know what I'd do. They tell me not to despair, but someday my prince will come along.
Maybe he has, princess.
Oh, if only it were true. If only.
We can make believe, can't we? Let's make believe.
Stars in your eyes, little one, where do you go to dream? To a place we all know, the land of.
Yeah.
pond to see you treating your stepdaughter in such a fashion.
Ah, a legal slip about marriage. Stepdaughter indeed. Leave us, girl, and take your utensils with you.
Oh, why are you so cruel to me?
Don't start sniveling! Get out! Get out! Leave us.
If Princess Snow White must leave, then I'm afraid I must leave too. Come, Snow White.
To talk to me like that. What are you so happy about, little monsters? Ah, hiss at me, would you? Ah, I'll cast a wicked spell on you. Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you will.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you will.
Quiet! Let me look in my magic mirror. Restore my confidence.
Let's fix this one's wagon once and for all.
After the way she treated us, she deserves all she gets.
Ah, there you are, Madam Coach's pair.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
I don't know, really.
And I couldn't care less. Ah, terrible tabletops and thundering toadstools! You must answer! I command you!
You, O Queen, are fair, 'tis true. Now Snow White's fairer far than you.
No!
Thank you.
If Princess Snow White must leave, then I'm afraid I too must go. Oh, he was wonderful.
Well, if he's so blooming wonderful, what are we doing here slaving?
Here you, bless of your God, that floor has been swept for a fortnight.
Well, don't look at me. I've only been here a couple of hours.
Aren't you the clever fella?
The prince had to leave for a while, and affairs were staged.
And look at the state of affairs.
I'd love to be in a pantomime.
Tell him, kids, you're in a panto.
Oh, no, he's not.
Oh, yes, he is.
Have you any stage experience, Osage?
No, but I'm your leg in a cast once.
I was in a play one time.
You never told me. Did it have a happy ending?
Oh, yes. Ever was delighted when it was over.
I think if I was in a play, I'd be so scared I'd kill myself.
Wonderful. And what would you do for an encore?
Ah, leave him alone. Mind him, Sausage. I'd say you'd be famous, signing autographs and all. Do you write with your right hand or your left hand?
I use a biro.
Two, thanks. Concentrate, you're knitting, Sausage.
I'm knitting a suit of armour. I have a tin opener as well, look.
What do you need a tin opener for? In the name
help,
of...
Somebody help! The Queen has collapsed.
Thanks be to God.
Mercy! What's wrong, Lord Chamberlain? What's happened?
Queen Sylvain was found in a dead faint in a mirror room. She's been moved to the bedchamber and the doctor's with her now.
Best news I've heard is in a pig's ear.
My brother has a pig's ear.
What?
My brother's ear was bitten off in a rugby match against my own kind. And the doctor had to sew on a pig's ear instead.
My God! A pig's ear? And could he hear with us?
Oh yeah, only for a bit of cracking.
There's no doubt the greatest underdeveloped area in the world lies between your ears.
I can open it with my chin opener.
Open yours.
It's Susan.
I'd love to hang your photo over the fireplace.
You would?
Yes, it would keep the children away from the fire. Right, slaves, this place is shiny. There's another 114 rooms in this place that needs attention.
That is, Sausage, that is, boy. Careful with your language. I told you he's short a sneeze or two.
When he passes on, do us all a favour. Have him cremated and have his ashes burned. Come, child. Chamberpot, follow on.
Coming, my love. Patters, before you come eat me, I want a post-mortem carried out.
A post-mortem?
To be awful to die and not know what you died of.
Sauce won't stop. You're not going to kick the bucket. Did I ever tell you, I once saw a man beheaded with his hands tied behind his back. And didn't he pick up his head and put it back on his shoulders again?
Well, how can you do that if his hands were tied behind his back?
He picked it up with his teeth.
Oh, he was brave.
He was. Then they chopped off his right arm, but you see, that didn't stop him. He rushed back into the enemy and grabbed them by the scruff of the neck and banged their heads together.
Well, how can you do that if you only have one arm?
You see, in the heat of the battle, he used to forget all that.
Oh, he was brave.
Like us, Sus, like us. Bold and brave and fit for anything.
But give me right hand to be ambidextrous like your man.
I know you would, old pal.
Friends for life.
For life. This song starts getting me down, and people are just
for free.
about ungrateful peasants. Oh, how dare you hiss at me! I'll put itchy feathers down your pants, and I won't let you scratch.
We were just going.
Ah, the jewels in my crown, my two newest employees. I have a little task for you.
Something tells me we're not going to like this.
You don't want me chin opener?
I don't know, but I say it once, I'll say it with a hammer.
Silence! You know that scullery maid, that ugly, loathsome creature, Snow White? I want you to take her deep into the forest and kill her! Kill her! Kill her! Kill her!
Easy, ma'am. You're scared. Shush, sugar.
When you've done the dastardly deed, I want you to take your heart out and bring it back to me.
I know, ma'am. That's very messy, and it's not very nice. How would you like it if someone...
Silence! Bring her heart to me, so I know you have carried out my command. Meesh, meesh. Gibbering jellyfish machines of scent. Banish your scruples, there's mischief afoot. Take Snow White and maiden to woods dark and deep. Their letters succumb to black bottomless sleep. And when breath is silent and light is still, extract vital organ and proof of your kill. But if you shall fail me, or conscience defeat, excruciating torment and torture your meat.
Sus, you hear what I'm hearing?
I think I'll plant me suit of armor.
I'm gonna keep me fingers crossed.
Me issue, me issue. Me issue, me issue. Me issue, me issue. Me issue, me issue. Peppery, peppery, peppery pingo!
To man it.
They couldn't swat a bumblebee. They'd faint at sight of blood to see.
And further complication grows when charming prince a-wandering goes.
The chamberlain makes awful wheeze. They're soon astray in mess of trees.
Oh, at last we've caught up. I'm puffed. But where are we going? I don't know. I think we're lost.
Oh, study the map. Can you see anything?
No. Put on your glasses.
Now can you see anything?
No, but it's much clearer.
But this is ridiculous. We're lost. Do something. Have you no get up and go?
Any get up and go I had, got up and went when I married Nurse Nightingale.
A fine woman.
But she's fair. She's always willing to come halfway. She'll admit she's right if I'll admit I'm wrong.
Oh, let me have a look at that map. Oh, Lord Chamberlain, it's upside down. There's the track, see? If we continue to the southeast, we meet the river here. Then due north, we meet the road here.
Let's go, everyone.
Wait, Chamberlain, about Princess Snow White.
Shh, Your Highness. Queen Sylvain has ears everywhere. No one's permitted to even speak of her. The Queen hates her so
but
much.
I don't understand. Princess Snow White is a lovely, sweet young lady.
Everyone loves her, Your Highness, except the Queen, of course. I think the Queen has her eye on you.
What?
Yes.
I'm afraid she's going to be disappointed. Princess Snow White is much more to my liking. I'll be along in a minute.
I feel it in my fingers, I feel it in my toes. The love is all around me, and so the feeling grows. On the wind, it's everywhere I go. So if you really love me, come on and let it show. There's no beginning, there'll be no end. 'Cause on my love, you can depend. I see your face before me as I lay on my bed. I kinda get to thinking of all the things you've said. I give my promise to you, and you give yours to me. I need someone beside me in everything I do. Oh, yes, I do. So if you really love me, I always will. My mind's made up by the way that I feel. There's no beginning, there'll be no end. 'Cause on my love, you can depend. I feel it in my fingers, I feel it.
My
I'm sure all the Rice Krispies are gone.
We got a new package yesterday.
Then I bet we have no sugar.
And knock it off. No, don't be such a misery.
I'm still having trouble controlling myself. What's this? Is it enough?
don't. There's some bad.
Rogers!
I feel like going.
Do something! Poor Sausage's gone mad! What's gotten into him?
What's gotten into him? Don't wait, the Queen's got into him, that's what. Sausage, will you turn him round? Queen Sylvain cast a spell on us.
A spell?
Yeah, an evil spell. Will you let go of the axe? Queen Sylvain is jealous.
Jealous.
So jealous that when the magic mirror told her you were more beautiful.
Me?
Yeah, she completely flipped her marbles and told us to take it deep into the forest. Well, and...
do something bad.
You mean the knife and the axe wasn't a game? Oh, how could you? I thought you were my friends. How could you?
We couldn't help it. She cast the spell on us, and only if I kept my fingers crossed, we'd be digging a 6x4 plot over there now.
Oi, are we saying spuds?
Oh, you mean just look out of there, you
know? I can see it now. Erected in memory of Snow White, who was accidentally stabbed and chopped into Kitty Cat as a token of her abiding affection by her friends Sausage and Ratters.
What are you going to do?
I don't know.
You're not going to kill me, are you?
I don't think so. What do you think, Sausage?
I think we'll set some cabbage as well.
Grant me patience. He thinks Pontius Pilate works for Aer Lingus.
Couldn't you return to the palace and tell the Queen you carried out her orders?
But what about the heart? Oh, what are we going to do? What are we going to do at all?
Couldn't you get a heart from the butchers on the way back?
The butchers?
Yeah, I sure the butcher'd have some kind of animal's heart, like maybe a sheep or something. Oh, please, Rashers, dear, please don't kill me. I promise I'll never return. No one will ever see me again.
But where will you go? And where will you live?
Here in the forest. No one will ever see me again. And no one will ever find out that you didn't carry out the Queen's command. You wouldn't have my death on your conscience.
Rashers, are we coming or going?
If I knew that, I wouldn't be here. Okay, if you promise never to return to civilization and stay hidden in the forest, we'll tell the Queen we killed you. Now lie down over there where Sausage is kneeling.
What?
Why? You've got to convince him you're dead. God knows what he'll tell the Queen.
Oh, I see. Are you sure?
Yeah, he'll believe it if he sees you lying down.
Rashers, what's she doing the vegetables?
She's dead.
She is?
As a doornail.
That's a pity. I liked her. She was nice.
Thanks, Sausage.
How are you doing? You're dead.
I'm not kidding,
really. Rasher said you were dead, and he knows better.
She's dead now, Sausage. We've got to leave her here and go back and tell the Queen.
It's a pity she died when she was out and tried herself.
There's nothing worse to being killed when you're having a good time. Let's go.
Now what's to become of me? Abandoned here in the forest. Oh, if only Nurse Nightingale was here. She'd protect me. Or my prince. Oh, if only. Sometimes I wonder where I've been.
Thank you.
help me through, help me.
Snow White. And I have nowhere to live at all.
Don't cry, please.
Maybe your friends.
And you can live in our cottage.
If you can fit in the door.
It's a very small cottage. Because they're small. Because they're in the dark. So the dwarfs are very big. And
I'll put a sock in it.
Let me see.
What are your names?
I'm the boss. So they call me Pope.
And I'm so sleepy they call me Mo.
I'm so happy they call me Hope.
And I'm so stupid they call me Dope.
I wash so often they call me Soap.
And I'm so doubtful they call me No.
And I eat while I'm nearly always drunk as a skunk. And I drink anything, even if an old shoe.
He's so boozy we call him Soap.
Wonderful. You're all so sleepy, thirsty, happy, charming, beautiful, wonderful, marvellous. I just know we're going to get on like a house on fire.
House on fire! I left the cooker on, the toast will be burnt, the vegetables will be frizzled, the porridge!
Oh, relax! I, in my usually efficient manner, fixed everything before we left. I'm not the boss for nothing, you know.
Did I say you were wonderful? Well, you are. And I just can't imagine the fun I'm going to have getting to know you. Getting to know you. Getting to know all about you. Getting to like you. Getting to hope you like me. Getting to know you. Putting it like nicely. You're beside
treaty between Queen Sylvain and Prince Charming.
I don't care if it's a love letter between Ian Paisley and the Pope. Get rid of it till I clean up.
How dare you interrupt an important meeting?
I have no intention of signing any documents between our kingdoms until Princess Snow White is present.
Princess Snow White? She's a nobody.
Nobody or somebody. I'm not signing till she's here.
Now see what you've done!
What I've done? I'd like to know where that child Snow White is and those two tulips you hired.
Never mind. Your Highness, Prince Charming, Your Highness.
Your signature, Your Highness. Your Highness. Oh, excuse me, Nurse. Go on!
There's something sinister afoot. I can feel it in my corns. Well, that doesn't change anything. Now, let's get to work. Now, has anyone seen Snow White?
No.
Anyone? Any idea where she might be?
Well, the last I saw her, she was headed towards the Enchanted Forest with the two new members of the staff.
Stamper, are you? Rashes and sausage. A bad breakfast that would give you a wind. Well, speak of the devil. Twins. Where were you and where's Snow White?
I'm not feeling well.
Why? Have you flu?
No, we got a lift on a tractor.
If you would like to see parts, I could have a more intimate chat with these two.
Are you sure you'll be alright? Can you manage on your own?
Oh, I'll manage alright. Goodbye now. See you later. Not you, you ham rasher. Now, where were you?
We went for a walk in the cemetery.
Huh. Who was dead?
All of them.
Are you trying to be smart?
Him? Smart? Sausage? What's Hitler's first name?
Heil.
Heil Hitler? That's an old joke.
So are your legs and you're still using them?
What about Snow White?
Do we know Snow White?
I don't think so.
Does he stutter all the time?
Only when he talks. If she insists on your man playing the snooker.
Who?
The Snow White one you're talking about. Jimmy White's sister.
What if the girls saw you going into the forest with her?
Oh, that's Snow White.
Yes, that's Snow White.
Well, Sesame said we were going fishing.
Huh. Fishing is prohibited in the environs of the forest.
Well, we were trying to teach a few worms to swim.
What about Snow White?
Well, just as old Saucier was giving us a demo of his karate.
What karate?
Oh, he's an expert in karate.
I can take a plank with one blow on my bare hand. I can...
Make smithereens of it. A great man in a fight.
Oh, I don't know about a fight, but if I'm ever attacked by a plank...
Well, anyway, when he was finished his demo, he turned around. And there she was, gone.
Who was gone?
Jimmy White's sister.
I give you Jimmy White's sister. If you don't give me a few straight answers.
Help, I go.
Now Joy is staring you in the face. 30 years on the chain gang. And a little hard labour thrown in for light relief.
I need somebody.
Help, not just anybody.
Help, you know I need someone.
To find out something.
Is this the change before death? Do you think I can trust her, boys and girls?
No.
What? Yes? No? Well, I suppose I have nothing to lose. Okay, your bigness. I'm leaving you here with these two dizzy disciples. animals. And I hope you can get some information about that poor child, Snow White.
If not, I'll be back and I'll make black puddings and rashids out of your intellect.
Anticipation.
Should someone be punished for something they didn't do?
What do you mean, something they didn't do?
Shut up, Sloth, shut up. It's time to flog a few lawyers. Now, Your Highness, we'll tell you exactly what happened.
Go on.
Well, we set off, and there we were riding our bicycles, and Snow White was walking behind.
Why was she walking behind?
Because she didn't have a bike.
So there we were with the cockroach powder.
Cockroach powder? Isn't that the stuff that's good for cockroaches?
No, it's not good for them. It kills them. You see, that's the way we had it.
Oh.
Well, seeing as how she was a princess and everything, we fired a 21 mud salute.
But we missed.
Is Snow White still alive?
No, she's still dead.
You see, that's when we made her drink the varnish.
Varnish?
She had a lovely finish.
And then I got out my penknife and chopped off her arms.
Twice pity for.
I kept chopping and cutting fingers, toes, eyes, everything.
I thought you was trying to get away bit by bit.
Until there was one bit of her left. One tooth lying in the grass staring at us.
One tooth, all that was left.
Worse still, she's having it out tomorrow.
So then we swept off pieces together and dressed her up in her new blue dress, the one with the pink sash, put on her new white shoes, bought a mini sale last week, put a ribbon in her hair, reddened her cheeks with a dash of lipstick. Beautiful.
If we knew she was going to look so well, we would have done it years ago.
Oh, but this will be wilder than bashful bedbugs. You shall be rewarded. Leave me till I consult my magic mirror.
No, Long John Silver said he got his wooden leg.
I think it's time to hop it.
You said it.
Oh, mirror, mirror, let me unveil. Come and tell me your latest tale. I know for sure Snow White is dead. There's only one thing to be said.
Oh, who's going to tell her, sister dear?
Oh, let me. I'd love to see her deflate of late in a state of hate so great.
Shh. Don't wax so lyrical, my dear. Let's do it together.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
You, O queen, were fair, tis true. Alas, that is no longer true. Your face is twist with sullen look. That makes you ugly in our book. We know to make you very sore, but as we told you once before, you, O queen, are fair, tis true. Now Snow White's fairer far than you.
Impossible! She's dead, do you hear? Dead, dead, dead!
Not so, queen of evil mind. The two you sent were far too kind.
They couldn't hurt a pussycat. They're far too meek to kill like that.
Oh, poison peanuts and perishing periwinkles. Oh, to be fool like that. Oh. Now, mirror twins, revert to form. You must make lands kick up a storm. I want no cheek or impudence. How will we make Snow White past tense?
You must go to Seven Dwarfs' home and bring Snow White this poison comb. If she still lives, the young Snow White, bring poisoned apple, make her bite. Disguise yourself as Lady Old, fool stupid girl with heart of gold. So take the apple and the comb and sally forth to Seven Dwarfs' home!
Ah, mangy magpies and mouldy mongooses, I must do the deed myself. I must discover where the Seven Dwarfs live. It seems that cursed no white is living there, but not for long. Not for long.
Where's she off to? And what's she up to? No good, I'm sure. But I just can't fathom Snow White's disappearance. Who's there? Somebody calling. Where are you?
Hey, you silly prat. Here in the mirror.
My goodness, a lady. Is this the Queen's magic mirror?
It is, and I'm Jacobina, the good twin. Not like my wretched sister Hydea, who has just given the Queen a poison comb and a poisoned apple.
A comb and an apple, both poisoned? What for?
To kill Snow White, that's what.
Kill Snow White? Are you mad? Where is she?
She's in the cottage of the seven dwarfs. You'd better follow the wicked Queen. Although she has a good head start, she took off on her broomstick like her ear was on fire. So get moving. Go.
The cottage of the seven dwarfs. I must get directions. But not from Lord Chamberlain. Oh, Snow White, do take care. I hope I'll be there in time to save you.
Another day is gone, and I'm still all alone. How could this be? You're not here with me. You never say goodbye. Would someone tell me why? Did you have to go and leave my world so cold? How did you slip away? Someone whispers in my ear and says, but you were not alone. I am here with you, though you're far away. I am here to stay, and you were not alone. I am here with you. You're always in my heart, and you were not alone. Just the other night, I thought I heard you cry, asking me to come and hold you in my arms. But I can hear your prayer, your burdens I will bear. But first I need you here, then forever can begin. Every day I sit and ask myself, how did you slip away? And someone whispers in my ear and says, but you were not alone. I am here with you, though you're far away.
Don't is so silly that she brings a ruler to bed to
see how long he can sleep.
If I'm clever, I'd take two hot water bottles to bed in case one of them leaks.
I'm glad to burst. Don't tell me we have to wash as well.
I had to go to wash last Christmas.
Oh, boys, boys, you must get up. You must get washed and say your morning prayers.
But I'm an atheist.
Oh.
Can't help it. It's the way God made me.
Don't you think it's about time you mended your ways, Lope?
I don't know.
Everyone was delighted when the prodigal son returned.
I bet the fat calf was.
Boys, boys, now up you get to say your morning prayers. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Lord, for another day. Keep us safe until tonight. And please, Lord, don't let Mope sleep all day. Make him get up as well.
Oh, you're here. You were behind before, so I'm glad you're a little late.
What a load of nonsense, Mope. Now, a little bit of exercise will do you good.
I feel like exercise. I lie down until the feeling passes.
Now be good, boys, and get dressed and off to work with you.
Oh, I couldn't be alone. We must rather be here with you.
Poor Aunt Glenn, smell you all night with Dick.
I'd much rather stay at home and guard you.
I have a sore toe. I can't walk.
Oh, let me see. There, does that make it better?
Well, what you mean is the Wicked Queen Sophia might try to harm you. And we all want to protect you.
I know, and I'd love if you all could stay.
Oh, God,
but I'm quite safe here on my own. Queen Sophia doesn't even know where I am. She's miles away.
But she doesn't
know. So, you go to work as usual, and when you come home, I'll have a lovely dinner on the table.
Yum, yum.
Oh, that sounds good.
I bet we won't have bangers and mash.
If you like.
And fish and chicks.
Of course.
And crisps and coke.
Absolutely.
Maybe even a fat calf.
Oh, don't be silly. Now remember.
Oh,
found such a haven. And there was I, with dreams of Prince Charming, and living happily ever after in a beautiful palace. But this cottage is so full of love, and I feel so safe here.
There's always fire in the kitchen. There's always a kettle on the boil. There's no fancy carpets, I know. Ten phones, that's the one thing our house is a home. Stranger is always welcome, be any time of night or day. So don't ever be sad or lonesome, just call if you're passing our way. There's always a fire in the kitchen. There's always a kettle on the boil. There's no fancy carpets or no telephone, but the one thing our house is our
woman passing through the forest. I saw your homely cottage and wondered if you would like to buy any of the little trinkets I have.
Oh, I have no money, but I could give you a little food.
That's very good of you, my dear. Can I come in and rest for a while?
Oh, what'll I do? The dwarfs warned me not to let anybody in, but she is only an old lady.
Can I come in and just rest for a few minutes?
Oh, I'm sure she'll be all right. Now sit down and rest, and I'll prepare some food for you.
In a moment, my dear. What lovely hair you have. I have the perfect thing for you. A beautiful Spanish comb.
Oh, but I have no money. Oh, it is beautiful.
Try it in your hair, my dear.
Oh, no, I couldn't really. Here, take it back.
No, no, my dear. Put it in your hair. I insist, a gift for all your kindness.
Oh, I couldn't really. It is beautiful.
Put it in your hair. Here, let me help. Kneel here beside me. Now, like this, my dear. Like this.
My lady, fairest in the land indeed.
Snow White, Snow White, oh, what am I going to do with you?
Everybody warned you.
Oh, what's the use of reapproaching you? Look at you, lying there, with the fancy comb stuck in your head. I'll have to summon someone to help. Let me concentrate.
Snow White, Snow White, are you there?
Time to go. Snow White, you'll be more careful in the future.
Don't be cross, Snow White. I have to come back for a message. That's what I told the others. But really, I only came back to tell you that my sore toe was nearly better. And I'm sure another kiss would really cure it. Snow White, Snow White, what's wrong? Snow White, talk to me. What's the matter?
I knew you were sneaking back for another kiss. That's not fair. You got going weak already.
There's something wrong with Snow White. She's fainted.
She was perfectly all right when we left. Did you say anything to upset her, though?
Honest, she was just lying there.
What's that?
Cool. Fancy cool.
Oh, she's okay. It was only a fain.
You get
fainted. I'll be all right in a minute.
But we're not going to leave you alone. Especially when Queen Sylvain knows where you are.
Queen Sylvain?
The old gypsy lady. Dope used to hear him watching the white while I go to the mine and tell the others.
Oh no, honestly, I'll be all right on my own.
Not another word. Dope, you're on guard.
Right, hurry back with the lads.
I'm gone.
Oh, I feel like such a fool letting that old gypsy woman fool me. Do you ever feel that way, Dope?
All the time. But don't worry, Miss Snow White. Just pretend you're happy when you're blue.
Doctor away.
But I don't understand.
I'm Queen of the Apples, when the fate of Piltown's epic show last Sunday. So here I am, giving apples to all and sundry.
Oh, I love apples, and I know you're only trying to be generous, but I don't really feel like eating an apple right now.
Oh, apples are very healthy, and as Queen of the Apples, I must insist that you eat one.
No, I mean, I can't. Thank you very much. But I've been warned and...
Warned? Warned about eating apples? They're full of vitamins. What are you afraid of? Look, I'll take a bite from this side, see? Mmm, yum, yum. Now you take a bite from the other side. It's safe.
No, I can't. No!
How do you like that, my lady? Fairest in the land indeed. Now the fairest of them all, Snow White.
I'm coming.
We're all coming, Snow White.
Princess.
Oh, we don't know. We came here and found her.
We couldn't bear to part with her, so I made this glass casket for her.
It's beautiful. She's beautiful.
It was all my fault. I was a fool to leave her.
Don't blame yourself, though.
You didn't know.
Anyway, I'm to blame.
Goodbye, my love. I always love you. That's all that counts.
Oh, Snow White, I'm so sorry. I was such a fool.
Oh, Dove.
I'm so glad we created a painting and succeed.
So am I.
You scared us.
I didn't mean to.
I had to wake up. I was so sad.
Oh, no.
And I almost decided to take the plan.
Everything was going to be all right. I knew you wouldn't go off and leave us just like that.
I know something wonderful is going to happen.
Oh, my friends, I promise I'll never leave you ever again.
Not even when you become my princess.
Oh, my prince, are you asking me to marry you? Well, what do you think?
Yes!
Oh, and you, my friends, are more than welcome to come and live with us in the royal palace.
Oh, yes!
Two's come from trees, crowds, but seven owls. I think we'll just stay here and visit you whenever we get the notion,
which will be very often.
And you can visit us lots of city life.
And I promise to never be stupid again.
Bye. There's work to be done.
What's work? I was just going to fall asleep.
Work? I knew something awful was going to happen.
We must find the most beautiful diamonds in the world for Princess Snow White's wedding tiara.
Hold
not under this hat. It's not under this hat.
No, it's under this hat.
Well, Nurse, you just missed the magic trick.
Well, here's a bit of diversion. We're having a floor show, and I'm mopping the floor with these two.
Let go.
Sorry to interrupt in these up chamber pots, but we've got to decide what to do with them. Not guilty.
No need for that. This is not a court. By the way, have you ever been in court?
No, this is the first time we've got caught. Are you guilty or not guilty?
I don't know till I hear the evidence.
Do you deny you took Snow White into the forest?
No.
Enough! Guilty as be damned! I think we'll banish you to some abandoned desert island. Ooh. Loneliness.
Ooh.
Hunger.
Ooh.
Thirst.
Ooh.
I mightn't be so bad. My brother was marooned on a desert island once. And one day, a beautiful native girl appeared. And the first night, she served him the most exotic drinks. And the second night, she served him the most delicious food. And the third night, well, on the third night, she asked him would he like to play a little game with her.
Janie, she had a football as well.
I sometimes despair of the human race. Tell me, boy, do you smoke?
No.
Drink?
Of course not.
How about women?
Mammy always minds me.
Viper, you're going to look a right aged in about 30 years' time, lying in bed, dying of nothing.
Are you really married to her?
Why, we're the perfect match. When we met, I met Lord Chamberlain, put all his cards on the table.
Access fees on American Express.
Aren't you the clever fella?
My brother gave his wife plastic surgery. My goodness, was she that ugly? Oh no, you just got off her credit cards.
I have it, ha-ha, I have it.
Well, I hope it didn't catch you.
The perfect punishment to fit the crime. Now, boys, you know marriage teaches you loyalty, self-restraint, and a lot of other qualities you wouldn't need if you stayed single.
Well, you see, we are single.
Not for long. Meet the terrible Swishery twins.
I don't go through with it.
Neither am I.
Does this mean we can escape from the magic mirror? Never have to answer the Queen's silly questions again? Oh, goody.
Let me see. Which one will I have? I think the mammy boy.
The minute you walked in the drawing room, I could tell you were a man of distinction, a real big spender, hey, big spender. Been a little time with me.
What a brilliant stroke of genius.
Work? Fantastic! I sipped a few into Chamberpot's tea one time. After one sip, he got up, kicked the table aside, threw me on the floor and ravished me.
Were you surprised?
Mortified! I never set foot in the carring again!
Thank you.
of this consternation in my palace. Wrinkling walnuts and wrinkling wellies, get back in the mirror and tell me I'm beautiful.
Too late, the maiden cries. You see, Queenie, I must explain a few things to you. Sit down there, girl. I'm glad and you're full. You see, Snow White is alive and well living here in the palace.
Oh, she's not, she's not, she's not.
She is, she is, she is. Don't get your underwear in a twist, Queenie. You see, Prince Charming gave Snow White a birdie, and boy, did she get alive. And the upshot of the whole caboodle is you're stripped of your queenly status and to become a maid. No, a servant. No, a slave. Here's your bucket and scrubbing brush. Now get to work.
Here they come. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm delighted to announce that the beautiful Princess Snow White is to become my bride.
Hold on, your nibs! You didn't ask my permission!
Oh, Nursey, just for once, stay quiet!
Now stay here!
It's right, Nursey. You see, I love him, and we're going to live happily ever after. And anyway, we did get permission from some very important people.
Oh, and who might they be?
Our friends. Pope, Hope, Soap, No, Tope. Soap and Mope. Mope, where is he?
Mope.
announce for ladies and gentlemen, one of our fairies' birthdays today. We want to sing, happy birthday to you.